After driving 2 hours, Juan is 110 miles from his home. After driving 5 hours, he is 275 miles from his home. What is his average rate of change? If we let r equal the average rate of change, r would be equal to the change in the distance divided by the change in the time. So in this case, the change in the distance would be 275 miles minus 110 miles. Let's leave off the units for right now and include them at the end. And the change in time would be 5 hours minus 2 hours. Well, 275 minus 110 equals 165. This would be miles. And then 5 minus 2 is equal to 3, which would be 3 hours. 165 divided by 3 equals 55. But let's leave this in fraction form. So we'll write 55 over 1. This represents 55 miles. And the 1 represents 1 hour, giving us our average rate of change. The average rate of change during this time period is 55 miles per hour. But let's also look at this graphically. If we labeled the x-axis hours and the y-axis miles, we could plot the given information on the coordinate plane. To represent that after 2 hours, Juan is 110 miles from his home, we would have this point here with coordinates 2, 110. And to represent that after 5 hours, he is 275 miles from his home, we'd have this point here with coordinates 5, 275. So now if we sketch the line passing through these two points, we would have this blue line here. And the slope of this line would be the average rate of change. So now we could use the formula m equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1, which would give us the change in the distance, and then divide by x sub 2 minus x sub 1, which would be the change in time, which would give us our average rate of change, which we found to be 55, or 55 miles per hour. The reason it's helpful to look at this graphically is that 55 miles per hour is the average rate of change, but we know from our experience, Juan did not drive 55 miles per hour for this entire time period. He probably drove faster and slower throughout this trip. So even though we found the average rate of change, if we compare the time and distance throughout the trip, his actual trip might have looked something like this, where he drove faster and slower throughout the trip. So the actual data might look something like this, but the slope of this blue line does represent his average rate of change, not his instantaneous rate of change throughout the trip. I hope you found this explanation helpful.